Hello, Attil.
Hmm?
What time is it?
5:15.
Hmm. Morning, everybody. We are in the Kruger National Park. And it's early. Okay, for this morning's game drive. 5D Mark III, 24mm 1.4, 7200 2.8 Mark II. What's this guy? Oh, 11-16 Tokino, wide angle. And then, of course, the trusty 35mm 1.4. It's my kit that I'm working with on this expedition. Here we're jumping in our trucks. Hyena. Hey, man. Hey, man. Oh, quick little litter pick. Oh, look, he's coming back out to say hello. Hey, man. Hey, man.
I'm sure people need him. Because they approach the vehicle.
Oh, they're just the sweetest thing. What up, hyenas? We pulled over and we were waiting for some information as to where they're darting a rhino or an elephant, because there's an elephant that apparently needs some treatment, some help. So we're going to try and meet up with that little situation. Should be quite interesting. Found another spider, so if you don't like spiders, look away. Oh, beautiful.
It's a golden orb, and now you need to look very nicely. You see these little shiny ones?
Yeah.
They're kleptoparasites, they're called dewdrop spiders.
Dewdrop spiders,
so they live
wow.
on this golden orb web spider's web. It's a female. Oh yeah, this is not a bad spider.
Bite?
No, there's only four venomous spiders for humans, and all of them are small, and these guys can't even puncture your skin.
Yeah, it's like my favorite animal as well, dude.
Okay, so what's happening is there's a lesser spotted wounded rhino. they've seen a wounded rhino which they suspect has been shot. So they're going to go and try and find the rhino, and when they locate it, we can then all go to that location. They're going to dart the rhino and see if there's anything they can do to repair the wound a little.
Mm.
It's going to be pretty average.
Yeah.
It's going to be amazing.
Yeah.
Rhino's really hope they find it. I really hope they find it.
Yeah, I really hope it's chilled and it's not going to be like put down.
Are we actually going to find the rhino?
I'd like.
Yes. Right, we're mobilizing. I wanted to use that term for a while. Everybody out. So what have we found? A rhino?
Yeah, it looks like it.
Awesome. Okay, so they darted the rhino. Now they're trying to kind of herd the rhino towards the road before it falls asleep. What up, bro? Sleep nicely. Have a little dose.
Must be so scary. Although
bless something.
I mean, like, right?
That is not something you see every day. These guys are filming a documentary about the vets. Shot in the foot as well, no?
From the neck through his back, probably while it was lying down. Fortunately, it's just a flesh wound. It doesn't look like any of his weight-bearing bones have been affected, because that's usually a fairly serious wound. So the chances of him recovering is very, very good. So by cleaning the wound and giving him treatment, we're just helping that along. But often if you just leave them like this, they actually recover themselves, because being rhino, they're quite robust. They fight a lot, so they have evolved to cope with flesh wounds quite well. Unfortunately, they don't cope at all when they've got a weight-bearing bone that's broken. unfortunately, most of the times then you'll have to euthanize them, because they just can't survive on their own. If they're still able to walk and carry on, what we can do, which we've done, you put a collar on them, and then you can follow up treatments in the field. And it's best to leave them where they are. They know where the water is, and they're familiar with the terrain. But this is unfortunately one of the really tragic side consequences of the poaching industry.
So the bullet has gone all the way through his neck, basically. Yeah. Shame, man.
I'm glad we got him, man.
It's gonna be all right, eh? All for this. And this stuff is made of the same stuff as my fingernails and your fingernails. It's just on a rhino, that's all.
It's DNA.
DNA?
You keep in a database.
What is this?
This is a microchip gun.
Microchip. Okay, the injured rhino has had a bit of a clean up and a little scrub down, and I've just mainly stood by emotionally trying to take some photos, but it's looking a lot better, and they're pretty tough. This guy's got two bullet wounds and he's still going, but the work here that these guys are doing is phenomenal. Okay, shortly we are going to be going in the helicopter,
yeah,
which is going to be awesome, but they're going to give this guy the antidote so that he wakes up and hopefully feels a lot better. He looks a lot better. Oh, you got this, just take a breather. Oh, almost. Yeah, you got this.
There you go.
That
quick, huh? As if
it's
never happened.
Later, buddy. Dude, what next? Elephants viewed from a helicopter? That would be amazing, wouldn't it?
I killed another one. I
heard this guy scruffling around. This guy was just scruffling around in the bushes.
Holy crap.
There's a baboon spider that's called. Kijk hierdie bobby handspin op
die tannie. Baboon spider, hey?
Yes! Check him.
Close his hole for a second. Is his hole?
Okay, it's our guy in the helicopter now. Very, very amped. You guys know how much I love helicopters. SP, what helicopter experience do you have?
I've gone in a helicopter once in New Zealand.
Yeah.
Here we go.
We're going. So these are the teeth, are they?
Yeah.
They look like tusks.
Yeah, these are the kind of incisors, yeah. But they're all sharp. These teeth are all for...
Yeah, it's quite weighty.
For home. These are the ones he chews grass with.
So they're the...
So they pull the grass off with their lip. The lip holds the grass.
Yeah. Lips.
Pull the grass off and then they chew with the
back. Like a cow.
But while these are chewing, these grind against each other all day, so that's why they sharpen so up,
ready for the fights.
You see how it's ground the bone here?
Yeah, it's incredible.
Run that by me again!
Yeah, that was lost in translation.
Lost in translation, yeah.
Wow.
The baboons are...
What's your favourite animal, dude?
Elephants.
What else?
What have we got over there?
I've upgraded my seat to the front so we can get the best knowledge from
anybody
for
a swim.
We've seen such great wildlife today.
Get out of the road, Gary.
It could take around about 12 litres of water into the trunk.
12 litres. Oh, that's just the best. Yeah. Thank you very much.
Thank you.
Okay.
Thank
you.
Successful morning, dude.
Dude, sick.
That's a good day.
Helicopter, elephants, rhino, darting a rhino.
Yes.
Check this guy out.
Oh wow, we're having a demonstration about the rangers and about the rhino protection unit. Okay, so this is our camp. Unite Against Poaching. This is where we were last night and we couldn't see. And there is no borders on this camp, so we had a couple of hyenas scruffling around the tents and such. We could hear a lion roar, but apparently it was 2 kilometers away. And brunch.
Yes!
We're currently learning about the guys on the ground and their setup and how they try and confuse the poachers and not give away the locations of the rhinos. It's very, very interesting. We are taking a little bushwalk and we're having some of the snares and traps kind of shown to us. Other alternative poaching methods other than just shooting with a rifle. It's super interesting, eh?
Yeah.
I'm really enjoying this.
I'm digging the whole education side.
Yeah.
More advanced.
There are several big, very big hippos. About 10 meters away, 20 meters away. And those things can be quite aggro.
Yo.
Hence the need for some firearms. Right now we're learning about all the different types of snares and traps. For not just catching buffalo, rhino, but all kinds of different animals, which are also on the close to extinction list as well, so it's not just rhinos.
It's a trigger mechanism. The string now is attached to this whippy branch that's providing tension onto the trigger. There's a little piece of the wood here. It walks along. Ooh. And it's caught around. I can't fly away, it's upside down. So the animal walks along. And a bird, and he's caught. This one is different, it's not whipping up over the neck. So the genet walks through from your side, steps on this branch. Oopsie, sorry for the video.
Yeah, it's caught.
Go for the food.
Oh!
Yeah, it's up.
So the grass goes on here, and this is a very small version, but hippos, the poachers aim to get the hippos, and they will step on there and have the bed of nails in their foot, and die about a week later. Yoi! This one is savage. I don't know if you guys can see.
You never know.
There's a spike.
You never know.
It's intense. And then you got yourself a strangled lion. Nailed it. So quick. What was that, 2 minutes? Yeah, that is awesome. with the gunpowder from the bullet.
Gunpowder from the bullet, yeah.
So awesome. We got company. We've got an Ellie checking us out. So we gotta go. Well, that got pretty intense. Yes, that was exciting. Being charged out by an elephant. Luckily, we've got these experts with us. Okay, we've been learning about how the anti-poaching unit are implementing dogs to track the poachers and how effective it really is in tracking down these poachers. And now we've got a nice little demonstration of these dogs. And they're so smart and they're having the best time ever, look. It's incredible the work they're doing. They've got really, really, they're increasing their percentage of catching the poachers so much just by having tracking dogs. It's mental, isn't it? I love it.
Hello, my boys. Hello, boysies.
You are so gorgeous. Yes. Oh, kisses to the viewers. Very good, sir. Thank you. We're learning about the wine. Rhino tears.
Cheers. And the wine. And so it's a wine made for everyday coughing, drinking, and we want people to buy this sort of wine and drink it in quantities.
Mm. Cheers. All right, we're back on the road. We're going for a little night drive. We've got some wine going down. Everybody's enjoying themselves.
What? You got the dude.
What? The cap.
Sorry. Not the cap on your head.
He
needs to go to the chiropractor, yeah.
Come back. Get him. Oh.
Go, giraffe. I mean, come, giraffe.
You having a good time, SB? What you got in your other hand? Show me. We're gonna find some aminals. Rhino!
Look, he's not used to
it,
did you see?
Mm.
It's
pretty
light. It's because the skin on his face is really tight, isn't
it? Oh, it's beautiful. We stopped for a pee break. We're looking for lion and stuff out here on the riverbed.
Got it?
Lions.
Tracks. There, and then there's a big one.
Oh, yeah. Ooh, that's nice. Oh, so they're going that way.
Look at that light kitty.
So they're going that way here, Niels?
Oh, yeah, it's walking.
No,
it's
walking to our right. That's a big one.
So they're probably the hyena.
What up, hyena?
She's just like a dog.
They hang around on the road because the road is warm.
We just heard there's lion in the road that way. So we're gonna go find them.
Oh wow. It's like the Lion King.
It looks so cool. Do the camera thing.
Do you mind taking the lamp for me, please?
Shot.
Shot. He's just chilling up.
Lion.
Oh yeah, that's the one. Oh, it's so contrasty, it's so nice.
Oh, it's a leopard, guys. It's a leopard.
So the campsite is just down the road as well, so we're chilling.
That is awesome.
guys, how awesome is that? Literally, about 20 meters from where we're staying, we saw a leopard. Unbelievable. SV, how stoked are you, bro?
Dude, what the hell?
I know, we've had the best day ever.
We were listing all the epic things that happened today, yeah. And the next thing you know,
a leopard.
Epic thing comes and lands on top, yeah. Of it.
It's crazy. We have had a crazy, crazy day. And yeah, I just wanted to let you guys know that the reason we're here, essentially, is to shed a light on Rhino Tears wine.
They're basically
like,
here, yeah.
Yeah, they brought us here, yeah. And they allowed us to be here and experience this, so thank you very much. But also I'm super amped because we've been talking to the guys who run the whole thing, and they raised so much money through selling bottles of wine for the actual conservation of rhinos, and they're telling us about all the different things that the money goes towards, and they're doing such a sterling job of protecting these rhinos, and that to the point where actually they're almost at the point where it's going to tip, the tables are going to turn, where the decline stops, and actually they're starting to win the battle, and it is a battle, it's like a war against the poachers, the rhino poachers. So it's really exciting to be involved in something like this, and I've been looking for something like this to get involved with for a long time. But yeah, amped, super amped. But I'm going to say goodnight to you guys now. I'll check you tomorrow. When we are going to have another day in the bush. Everybody else is going home, but we're staying one more night. I don't know where we're staying or how we're going to do it, but it's going to be good fun. So I'll check you then. In the meantime, remember to work hard, be nice to people, and try not to get lost or killed. Okay, I love you guys. Goodbye.
At least the first six.
No, I'm putting in enough bullets, so if nobody listens to me, I'm allowed to lose 15% of my guests per year.
Exactly.
And it's the nice thing about these big caliber rifles is we can line people up and use one bullet to kill three or four. How does that sound for a plan?
Oh, just spotted